إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. نشهد يا رسول الله أنك قد أديت الأمانة وبلغت الرسالة ونصحت الأمة وكشفت الغمة وجاهدت في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاك اليقين، فجزاك الله عنا خير ما جازى نبيا عن أمته ورسولا عن رسالته. أما بعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, today's topic is about identity. Your ID. Who are you, أخي? Who are you, أختي? What will you be known for? What will your legacy be after you die? What will you leave behind? When you come into the masjid, do you think you're the best one amongst us? What's in your heart? What's in your mind? What's in your soul? How will it leave your body? How will you end up? Where will you be going? What's the purpose of your life? Too many questions, rhetorical they may be, but they come together in a place that will be eternal. May Allah make it the Firdaus al-A'la. Ameen. This piece of ID, we'll call it your passport. In it you will see your picture, your name, your date of birth, your address, your height, weight, eye color, hair color, and an expiration date. Some visas, places you visited. So let us check this passport of yours. You will never look at your passport the same ever again. Let us start with your name. What's your name, أخي? What's your name, أختي? Is it Muhammad or is it Mo? Is it Fatima or is it Queen Latifah? What will you be called for? Not more importantly in this dunya, but in the hereafter. Have you ever thought of that? When the angel of death comes to take your soul away, and it leaves from your toes upwards, the last place it leaves the top of your head, and that's why your eyes are rolled up to follow your spirit as it leaves your body. As you ascend, What will you be called? By the best of names that you were called in this dunya, or by the worst of names of the called in this dunya? On Judgment Day, what will you be called? Aina Fulan ibn Fulan? Where is the soul, the son of soul? Will you know who you are? Someday names will abolish, will perish. You will either be called a mu'min or a kafir, a believer or a disbeliever. Which one will you be? Now, your birth date. Most of us think the date I was born. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullahi alayhi, he says you have two birth dates. The first then, the one that you were born, that's your first birth date. Your second birth date is the day that Allah blessed you and granted you tawbah. Let us go back in history. Time and a place where the best of creation that ever walked upon the earth lived with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'een. Ka'b ibn Malik radiallahu anhu. The story is long, we don't have time to go into it. But let us take it to the end. When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came in the Masjid al-Nabawi, may Allah grant us shahada there, ameen, after a long, health, righteous life. He looked at him, smiled with anger. He wanted to repent. He defaulted on jihad when he was called. He had no excuse, he said. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him through the test, as you will be tested in this dunya, in the hereafter. He was tested. You will be tested. I'm not talking about the one that some of you will have in a few days. May Allah give you great success. Ameen. But now he had a choice to make. When the kings come and says, I heard your friend is treating you this way. You're being banished. Ousted. Even your wife left you. Not in divorce, but she was asked to leave. And he was committed so much that all these tests and trials he passed with flying colors, but he was honest with himself that he wanted to hold on to the banner of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah is the best testimony for you in this life and the hereafter. Nothing is more important than that. He never compromised on his values. So he held on, went back, asked for Allah to forgive him on that day where he went back after the revelation of the Quran that Allah granted him tawbah. He goes back to the masjid, prostrates to Allah as soon as he heard the good news to thank him for the tawbah. When he goes back to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when people are coming to hug him, why did they hug him? Because he won the lottery? No, because Allah granted him repentance. They have their priorities straight. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, Abshir, glad tidings. Basharakum Allah bil Jannah, ameen. He says, Abshir bi khayr yawm, the best day that the sun is risen upon since your mother has given you birth. So he says, the second birth date is the date that Allah granted you tawbah. And don't ever forget it. Keep it upon your sight to keep you on the straight and arrow. Never to go back. As you remember that day, in Jannah, you remember the day that Allah granted you with tawbah. So may Allah grant us tawbah before we die. Ameen. Your height. Sittuna dhira'an fi as-sama', 60 arms length. Your necks, are you like the muadhin? Longest necks. Where is your height come from? Do you say ha ana dha, here I am, O Allah, or do you say my father is this, my grandfather is that, or do you do something about it? What's your height? Is it the measurement tape? No. Your height, ya akhi, in the sight of Allah. Are you big or small, tall or short? Allah does not look at the heights, doesn't look at the bodies, looks within you. So what's your heart like, akhi? Full of hatred or full of love? Love of Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula comes first and foremost, or the hubb of dunya, or the love of that, this life. Worldly possession. We're not saying it's haram, wallahi. قُلْ مَنْ حَرَّمَ زِينَةَ اللَّهِ الَّتِي أَخْرَجَ الْعِبَادِ وَالطَّيِّبَاتِ مِنَ الرِّزْقِ. We're not making anything that's halal to be haram. حاشا. لا والله. We're not saying that. But we're saying, قُلْ إِنْ كَانَ آبَوْكُمْ وَأَبْنَوْكُمْ وَإِخْوَانُكُمْ وَعَشِيرَتُكُمْ All this. If all these eight categories are more beloved to you than Allah, your fathers, your children, and your brethrens, and your whole tribe, your money, your businesses, your dwellings, your homes, more beloved to Allah, and striving for His sake is more beloved to Allah in your heart than that. فَتَرَبَّصُوا فَاتَّعْقِيبُ right away. So wait till Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees His manner. Check. Is it full of iman? Strength inshaAllah. What about your address? How many of you moved so many times? How many of us had to go change the address? Return to sender, does not live here anymore. Moved countries, cities, continents, everything. That's why it's called Dar al-Qarar. The place where you're not going to move anymore. May Allah grant us that, Ameen. Your address, akhi, where would it be? Will you settle for less? You work so hard in this dunya to get a place that you can call your own. How could you not be striving for a castle of silver and gold, a brick of silver, a brick of gold? Where will your address be? Who will your neighbor be? Will it be Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? But does your actions, talk, walk, life, reflect that? Do you really want it? وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَلَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا Those who strive in our path, we'll guide into our ways. If you really want it, you can have it. But إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيْرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ Allah will not change you unless you change within yourself. So do you want it? When you look at a person in that mirror, that's yourself, do you respect that person? Do you have a life or do you have a lifestyle? Where do you live, akhi? Where do you live, ukhti? A place by the water? Alhamdulillah, may Allah bless it for you. But what I'm asking, where will your address be in the hereafter? How hungry are you for Jannah? Do for the dunya بقدر بقاءك فيها or مقامك فيها. Do for this dunya as long as you live in it. Give it that, what it deserves. But do for you hereafter, how long you're staying in the hereafter, give it that worth. عجبت للنار كيف نام هاربها وعجبت للجنة كيف نام طالبها. I wonder, if you want to run away from the hellfire, how do you sleep all night? And if you want that Jannah, how do you sleep all night? Subhanallah. How much do you want it? And do for the hellfire as long as you can withstand it. When Umar radiallahu anhu used to place his hand on a candle flame, he said, أَلَكَ صَبْرٌ عَلَى مِثْلِ هَذَا يَا ابْنَ الْخَطَّابِ Can you hold on? Can you withstand this pain? It's not a sunnah, don't do it. I'm putting a disclaimer, please do not try this at home. But at least keep that in mind. And Jannah, how much do you want it, akhi? Allahu Akbar. With that journey, we'll continue after Jalsa Istiraha, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who listen to speech and follow the best of it. Wa akhir da'wan, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, aqulu ma tasma'una, astaghfiru lakum, fastaghfiru, fa ya fawza al-mustaghfirin. الحمد لله وحده، والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده، أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, you have a mission in this life. You have a goal to attain. You cannot be another number or statistic. You cannot just settle for less. A true believer always fights for what's best and keeps Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ulah, Islam and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in mind in everything they do. So be the best doctor, Muslim doctor, be the best Muslim engineer, be the best Muslim lawyer, be the best whatever it is. Turn ada into ibadah with your intention, with your ikhlas. You're here for a reason. So let's do it for the sake of Allah, not because your parents pushed you here, brought you here from overseas to learn in an Islamic environment and you hate it. La wallahi, turn the positive into a negative. At least you're blessed that you're in the righteous environment. So how do you do that? The scholars will tell you, you can turn an ada into ibadah, any tradition, any culture, any act into an act of worship with your intention. So you're studying, Ya Allah, I want to take this ummah again the front. I want to lead by example. I want to be successful in this university so I can get a degree, so I can get a good job. I can help the ummah. I can help another sister. I protect myself, protect her, raise righteous children. All these multiple intentions, like the Sahaba radiallahu anhu ajma'in, used to be businessmen. Smart, intellect, al-Muslim kayyis fatin, al-Mu'min kayyis fatin. A true believer, intellect, smart, intelligent, calm, cool, not brainwashed. Now, it is too much to share with the ID and too little time. So let us go with the expiry date and then we'll finish with your visa, inshallah. Expiry date. Any guarantees, akhi? I don't mean the expiry date on your milk when you know it's fresh or not. Expiry date for this passport is the expiry date for your life. Anyone knows when they're gonna die? Guaranteed? No. Do you come with instructions? No. You come with a manual. Your manual is Quran, yes. And in it, it says no one knows when the time is. Only Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula. When a man came in the Masjid Nabawi, when he asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was talking, he says, Mata sa'a? When is the time? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam continued. Some of the Sahaba says maybe he was angry when he said that. He did not want to answer him. Some of them says maybe he did not hear him. After he finished his lecture, he says, Aina sa'il? Where is the one that asked about the time? He's here I am, alayhi salatu wasalam. Oh ya Rasulullah. What did he say? Did he say the sun will rise from the west? The 10 signs are in the hadith, the major and the minor signs? La wallahi. He asked him another question. مَا أَعْدَدْتَ لَهَا? What have you prepared for that time? What have you prepared for that time? Can I ask you another rhetorical question, أخي and أختي? And please be honest with yourself. If you put your head on the pillow tonight, are you ready for that head not to come up again? Are you ready for that eye to close, not to open again? Are you ready for that breath to come out, not to come back again? Are you ready for that last pulse of your heart? If we're truly honest, we'll say no. So what are you waiting for? مَا يَحُولُ بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَ التَّوْبَةِ? What's holding you back? It's time, wallahi. أَلَمْ يَأْنِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَن تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ? Isn't it time for the true believers for heart to tremble by the remembrance of Allah? Come back to Allah. What are you waiting for, أخي and أختي? Before you leave this masjid right now, your intention is I repent, Ya Allah. I tried everything in this life. It's not working. I'm not happy. I'm not secure. I don't feel the sincerity. Iman is weak. My relationship with Allah. أصلح ما بينك وبين الله يصلح الله وما بينك وبين العباد. Repair the relationship between you and Allah. Allah will repair the relationship between you and every other creation of Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula. What comes first? You say manana when you hear Allahu Akbar. I'll get it when I have time. I hear the adhan, but I'm watching a movie. The movie is more important to me than the beloved. La wallahi. I have to finish this soccer game. I'm watching my country, man. حب الوطن من الدين. والله موضوع. Fabricated hadith. It's not hadith, يا أخي. That I love my family and country and I have to watch the cricket game, I have to watch the football game or soccer game for the what? Allah. Ya akhi, you hear a muadhin, a caller saying Allahu Akbar. Allah is greater. By your actions, they're saying no, Allah is not greater. This movie is more important to me. Subhanallah. Coming back to Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula, it's time. It's now. Before you leave that door, you better have your intention. It is time for me, O Allah. Fafirru ila Allah. Not fafirru min Allah. Flee, haste, back to Allah, not to away from Allah. Will you be abd abiq? Two. One will run to Allah, one will run away from Allah on Judgment Day. The one is the one that is a slave that ran away from his master. Like the cops come running to you or for you, running away. Is this who you want to be on Judgment Day? Or you want to run to Allah like you haven't seen your family for long? You miss them so much. You run with open arms, hug and kiss and embrace your family members. Is this who you want? Yes, of course, that's what you want. What else do you want? فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ فَقَدْ فَازْ. True success, يا أخي. Distance yourself and أختي away from the hellfire. Attain heaven. That is a true success. But to be successful, you have to pay your dues in this dunya. It's your test. So think about this test that you will be taking. And imagine yourself taking that test and waiting for that report card. How would you feel when you wait for your report card? Your heart trembles. Things are waiting. People are waiting. What's your report card say? A plus or Z minus? You're thinking what? Yes, this will get me another job. This will take me up one notch. This will get me that. This will get me this. But have you not thought about that report card on Judgment Day? It is not a job. It is not another day. It is not another environment. It's heaven or hell, akhi and ukhti. So what will your hand say? What will your eyes say? What will your mouth say? Senses, limbs, whims and desire. So from now on, a takeaway. I want you to think that your eyes are like camera lenses. Your ears and mouth are your MP3. Your mind is your modem. Your heart is your hard drive. Everything you see, everything you hear, everything you say is downloaded and recorded. And it will be uploaded on Judgment Day. Will you be proud of that DVD? That you will see on Judgment Day. على رؤوس الأشهاد. Finally, visa. Welcome aboard, sir. Or rejected. Sorry, sir. Imagine yourself on Judgment Day. 50,000 years. Sun left its orbit. Everyone says, nafsi, nafsi. Myself, myself. Your name is called. No one else will move except you. Abdi, my slave. Do you have an excuse? Do you have a reason for not praying? Do you have a reason for not doing this? And. The questions that you'll be asked. Your ilm, your knowledge, what have you done? Your youth, your age, what have you done? Your strength, what have you done? Your wealth, where did you get it from? How did you spend it? Do you have the answer? Have you not heard in this dunya they will not give you the test? Have you not heard they will certainly not give you the answer? But only Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula by His mercy gives you the test and gives you the answer. No one else will do that in this dunya unless you bribe them. He tells you the questions on Judgment Day is 1, 2, 3, 4. He tells you in the hadith that the questions you will be asked in the grave is 1, 2, 3. مَنْ رَبُّكْ مَا دِينُكْ مَاذَا تَقُولْ فَالرَّجِلِ بُعْثَ فِيكُمْ Who is your Lord? What is your religion? Who is your prophet? Are you ready to answer the question? Will you have someone to help you? لا والله. Will you be able to say, could I call a friend? Is this my final answer? There is no lights and music. Da 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 da. You will not hear that in your grave, akhi. You're on your own. The scholars teach us when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, you will be followed by three things in your janazah: family, wealth, and your actions and deeds. Family will go back. Wealth will go back. Ibn Uthaymeen rahmatullahi alayhi in the Sharh of Riyad al-Salihin, he says, even your family, the one that come and run, hug you, will leave you alone. Even if you tell them, take him back, they will tell you, no, I can't take him back. Your wealth, the people that worked for you, the people that you actually helped to be rich, they will not take you back. The only one that will stay with you in your grave are your righteous deeds. So he says, أحسن الرفيق. أحسن الرفيق. Be smart. Look for the one that will stay with you in your grave, your righteous deeds. Are you bankrupt with your righteous deeds? Have you deposited anything with the bank of Allah? Are you a smart business person? Yes, inshallah. I now know that. Imagine. The last thing we'll say is the visa. I respect your time. Visa to Jannah. How much would you pay? How much would you pay to have the pleasure of Allah eternally, to live eternally, no longer of sickness, sadness, poverty, illness, sadness in the heart, mind, anything? Having this beautiful castle you earned. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is your neighbor. You can actually see Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula in the way befitting His majesty. Allahu Akbar ya akhi. What else do you want? You don't have to do aerobics anymore. You don't have to impress anybody anymore. You don't have to buy flowers and chocolates and poetry. Allah will give you that beautiful masterpiece in Jannah. That's what we should end with. وَفِي ذَٰلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ In that, in such an act, we should compete. فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ Finishing off with فَى التَّعْقِيب right away. Do not delay, do not procrastinate now. لام If the لام goes into فعل مضارع in the present tense, توجب الطلب والأمر. It means request and a command. فَلْيَتَنَافِسْ فَلْيَتَّقُوا اللَّهِ Isn't it time finishing with it? أَلَمْ يَئِنْ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْ تَخْشَعْ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ Isn't it time for those who believe to come back, their heart trembled by the remembrance of Allah? It is time, wallahi. We should want to be distant away from the hellfire and attain Jannah and remember who you are. Who your ID is, what will you be called for? Work toward it, akhiya, there's no tomorrow, no guarantees. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us Jannah with no punishment and accountability. Wa akhir da'wam, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallam a'ali wa sahbihi wa tabi'een. Ya Rabbana laka alhamdu kama yanbaghi jalali wajhik wa azim wa sultanik. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad fil awaleen wal akhirin wa fil mala'il a'la ila yawm al-deen. Allahumma ansur al-islam wa izzal muslimin wa a'li bi fadlika kalimatay al-haq wa al-deen. Wa adhil al-shirka wal mushrikeen a'da'aka a'da'a al-deen. أوقع الكافرين في الكافرين وأوقع الظالمين في الظالمين وأخرجنا من بينهم سالمين اللهم احفظنا بالإسلام قائمين واحفظنا بالإسلام قاعدين واحفظنا بالإسلام راقدين ولا تشمد بنا الأعداء ولا الحاسدين اللهم احفظنا من بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعن أيماننا وعن شمائلنا ومن فوقنا ونعوذ بعظمتك أن نغتال من تحتنا أقول ما تسمعون فما كان فيه من صواب فمن الرحمن وما كان فيه من خطأ من نسيان فمني ومن الشيطان والله ورسوله منه براء وأعوذ بالله من ذكر وأقم الصلاة